It's all right. I'm coming.
It was a crazy drunken dream, and yet it was more than that. It was the truth, a suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned
Alice?
The lights off.
Alice!
I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript. I couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
Okay.
A dark presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me, made me her puppet.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You laugh at the whole thing together and put it behind you.
Alice!
She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you, right? You.
Yeah, sorry for the crash there, everyone. I don't know what happened.
Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes. All right. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back. No. I wrote it.
I remembered it all now. In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish, to interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone.
Okay, so that's interesting.
And far away. But I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. It stole the skin of my partner a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
There's an altar rod with mystery upon the pole. Two more episodes, and then we're done.
Previously on Alan Wake, under the influence of the Dark Presence, I wrote a horror story that is coming true. Jagger had been my editor, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Together we can create something absolutely wonderful.
The lake, it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. My mom gave me this old light switch.
The clicker.
Alice is being kept in a dark prison. I need to find Cynthia Weaver to fix this.
It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Well, we're expecting a record crowd from the neighboring counties. Naturally, we hope to break the record set by last year's Moose Fest in our neighboring town, Watery. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have asked me, what's the big deal about Deer Fest? And I think that this sums it up. It's about friendship and community. We've got a great party coming up. Let's try to hold it in until tomorrow and get through the night in one piece, all right?
Someone will come for it when the time is right. Thomas said so. He wrote it. The key is insurance. It's my job to keep it safe. Safe in the light. What was in the light?
Hello. Hello.
All the manuscript pages were gone. The FBI agent had taken them.
I think my tongue just took a crap in my mouth. Ugh. Oh, wait, we're in jail now? Al, this is not good.
That about sums it up.
Oh, sorry for the yawn, folks. Pushing myself today.
Never drinking again.
I need to talk to Weaver. She's the one in the song, the Lady of the Light.
What, the crazy lady? Ugh, whatever you say, Al, but we're stuck here. They're not gonna...
She's been interviewed, Wake.
I had some reading to do first, Sheriff. And let me tell you, it was an interesting read. Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent. There's no way you're walking out of here. You hear me in there, Brett Easton Ellis? Huh?
Agent Nightingale, I want to talk to your superior.
Well, we all want things, Sheriff. I wanted my... Look, that's not possible right now.
Agent Nightingale, I insist. Wake, what's wrong?
Lady, are you stupid? It's a trick. It's an obvious trick.
Okay, I've had enough of this crap. Wake, I'm gonna trust you with this.
You're joking.
Agent Nightingale, your opinion would matter more if you were sober and if I actually believed you were here on official business.
Whoa! Get back in the cell, Stephen King. The only way you're leaving this place is over my dead...
Wait a minute. I know...
Oh my God!
Light. We need light. It's the only way to fight this thing.
In my office. I've got your things there. Follow me.
Oh man! We're sitting ducks with the lights out!
Stay cool. I can get the emergency power on.
Oh.
Here are your things. Wake, what do I need to know? What do you need from me?
They can be hurt in the light, only in the light. And I need to find Cynthia Weaver. She can help me stop this.
Light. Check. Cynthia. She lives in the old decommissioned power plant. I can get you there pretty quickly in the rescue chopper. Come on, let's get back to your friend.
Okay, just make sure I have everything.
I need your help.
Well, okay.
Here's a list of people and phone numbers. I need you to call them and tell them you have a message from me. Night Springs, okay? They'll know what to do.
Night Springs? Like the TV show? Gotcha. Oh, hey, that radio guy is on the list. Maine. Who's Frank Raker? He related to you?
My dad.
Hey, is this like a secret society?
Can you do this? You'll be safe here. The backup power's on. These guys need to be alerted, just in case we don't come back.
You'll come back for me, though, right?
As soon as we get the chopper ready. Thanks, Wheeler. I owe you one.
Oh, I didn't even know there was extra stuff.
Okay, let's go, Wake. Through the back.
Hello, Mr. Breaker. This is Barry Wheeler.
Whatever took Nightingale must have broken the gate controls. We can't reach the gate's control box from here. We need to get to the other side over the rooftop.
I'll go. I'll open the gate for you once I'm across. You stay here in the light and cover me, Sheriff, okay?
All right, through here. Not through here. Auda, thank you for the lurk, my friend.
I needed to reach the rooftop to get to the other side of the broken gate.
Come on. Nope. How the hell? How am I supposed to reach the rooftop?
sheriff.
No real way to access the rooftops. God damn it. Do I have to go back in? No, so it's somewhere here. There we go. See if there's anything to collect here. Shouldn't need to use these for travel trips. Oh no. Well, fell to my death.
Springs? What's that all about?
It's a stupid joke we have. That Bright Falls is the original inspiration for the TV show. This town can get weird at times. Never this weird, though. You need to bypass the damaged control box.
What am I, an electrician? Hold on!
Ah, damn! That's smart.
Good job, Wade. Okay, stick close. Our first stop is the town hall. The keys to the chopper are there. Over here, Wade. The chopper's in the other direction.
Okay. Okay. But there is a cache, and I need to get that cache to survive.
Good job, Wade. Okay, stick close. Our first stop is the town hall. The keys to the chopper are Look out!
Is this pointing here? There it is. Okay, everyone's fully stocked up. Let's go. I didn't know that was a thing you could do in this game. She's upstream. She's trying to use a gun as protection. That's crazy.
Over here! There's light! I have a key. Watch my back, Wade.
What?
It's an ambush.
There we go. Go.
Let's go, Wade. Okay, someone's messed with the fuse box here, but you should be able to jury-rig it while I find the keys.
I already got electrocuted once today. How about I look for the keys and you get burned for a change?
Fine. They should be in the clerk's office on the other side of the building, near the main entrance. The keys aren't upstairs, Wake.
I'm just gonna take a quick look.
You have no clue what's in here, man. Can't tell me where to go, not go.
The message was from Barry. He was getting worried at the station. He wanted us to hurry.
Come on, there we go. Jesus, Dark. Why the hell are there flashbangs here?
Okay, Sheriff, I got the keys.
Barry?
Why isn't he inside?
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Barry, look out! Barry, move!
He made it inside, Wake. He's okay.
Shit's getting intense.
Come on, Wake. Let's go around. We can meet him in the back.
Trust no one in the dark. Of course. Batteries, not good.
We can make it through the bookstore. Hey, Wheeler should be waiting for us in the backyard.
Keep the hell down, or I'll call the sheriff.
Oh, hi, Doc. I've got it. Don't worry about it.
Sarah, about time somebody showed up. All the shooting in the air is idiotic. One of these days, they'll kill somebody. And over Deerfest.
I know! Go back to bed! He's got a point, Wake. Look, this town can't take this.
It's me they want. The sooner I get out of here, the sooner you can all get back to life as usual.
Life as usual.
Right. Come on, let me get this door open.
Wait, you got the keys to the bookstore?
Perks of being the sheriff. A girl needs to get around. They're really taking advantage of your presence here, Wake. I heard they're selling a lot of your Alex Casey books.
Right now, I'm not a big fan of my own writing.
Nothing.
See Barry.
Look, wait. Maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
Nice. Let's press forward. Oh boy. That wagon kind of scared me. Is there anything more? Anything? Manuscript page? Okay. I should see what's going on.
Nightingale tried to make sense of the manuscript. It was disjointed and strange. He didn't understand half of it, but it all rang true. Impossibly true. He took out his hip flask when he reached the page that described how he reached the page that made him take out his hip flask. It wasn't the booze that made his mind reel.
Oh no. Okay.
Nightingale felt the situation veering out of his control, but the gun at least felt steady in his hands. He was ready to fire, resolved that he would let this happen over his dead body. And yet he hesitated. He had seen this moment before, read it in the page. He was transfixed by the deja vu and the horror that he was a character in a story someone had written. Then the monstrous presence burst in behind him and dragged him into the night.
All right.
The darkness that wore Barbara Jagger's face was furious. The story in the manuscript had been making it stronger all the time, but now the light had set the writer free and hurt it, weakened it. It was only a matter of days before the dark presence would be strong again, but meanwhile, it would be difficult to recapture the writer. Cynthia Weaver worked hard, following her obsessive rituals, sometimes fighting them, always giving in to them in the end. She haunted the halls of Bright Falls' abandoned power plant. She marked her caches with light-sensitive paint that could only be seen by eyes that had been touched by darkness and saved by light like she'd been. She was preparing defenses and supply lines for the war she knew would come. The war between the forces of light and darkness. Barry got back to his feet inside the Bright Falls General Store and dusted himself off. Right next to the cans of baked beans was a locked case filled with flare guns, and yet here was a conveniently placed barrel of crowbars. Barry's smile widened as he realized that this was the classic movie scene where the hero had to gear up and arm himself to the teeth. Barry threw himself into the role.
I think that's everything.
I'm gonna give Pastor Howard a piece of my mind about this lock. I told him to get it fixed.
All right.
Okay, it's open. Let's go, Wake.
Wow.
We keep them lit all night long on the night before Yearfest.
Why?
Well, it's tradition.
That's some weird tradition.
For it to be free, the Dark Presence needed the writer to finish the story. Again and again, the story let it get frustratingly close to the writer without letting it capture him. It was bound by the events depicted in the manuscript. But it could pursue the writer indirectly, put others on the task, and stop those who would help him. It took over everything in its path, made them its puppets, and sent them after Alan Wake.
We're almost there. We'll have to go through the basement to get to the parking lot.
Yeah, there's no way going through the crypt will turn out to be a bad idea.
I'll let you lead. Need to see if there's items. Fortunately, you gotta scavenge.
Tough audience.
Well, I got plenty more.
What are the Christmas lights for?
Protection, man. Like garlic against vampires.
Vampires.
The helicopter's just across the parking lot and up the hill. Come on.
Okay, I'm gonna need this.
General Store is now my favorite place in the entire world. See this headlamp? It's like a superpower. I can just look at one of those things and they die. It's my flaming eye of Mordor.
God damn it.
I wish I didn't say that.
Yeah.
Hey, I want a headlamp.
Last one.
Bastard.
Alice had screamed until she had no voice left to scream. Around her, the darkness was alive. It was cold and wet and malevolent and without end. She was a prisoner, trapped in the dark place. The terror would have burned her mind out, but one thing made her hang on. She could sense Alan in the dark. She could hear him. She could see the words he was writing as floating shadows.
Oh man, I might have to save the last episode of that. Ooh.
bunker's just up ahead. I'll need a while to prep for takeoff.
Don't take too long. I want to get out of here.
What? God damn it, that all came out of nowhere. Fuck. Talk about prep. Really? But I'm gonna lose all this anyway, so it wouldn't matter. As far as the helicopter was able to get out, it's only the first couple episodes.
I hope you know how to deal with this, Wake. I guess you New Yorkers.
carried a gun until a couple of days ago.
Well, my dad used to be a cop there. Tells some pretty wild stories.
Stuff like this?
No, no. Just normal bad stuff. Kind of like your books, Wake. I used to tease Dad that he was just like Alex Casey.
You've read me.
Oh, sure. You're a pretty good writer. A little heavy on the metaphors, maybe.
Nobody's ever said that before.
We're coming up on the power plant. See the lit building over there? And that's the dam further up the river. I can't land here. I'll take her down the road across the river.
Just get me there, Sheriff.
Oh, of course. God damn it. Can't go in here. Gotta be fucking kidding me. Son of a bitch. Oh my god. Yeah, of course. Of course. Like, fucking... I guess I gotta explore some more then.
I had to do something about the chain for the door to open.
God damn it. Shit. God damn it. This so much. I think it's a good story. It's just
and here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the Old Gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just, you know, one of those things. Anyway, here's Poets of the Fall and their latest single.
God damn it. Christ, these guys hit like a truck. All right, let's go.
The power plant glowed in the night. It was close, but I had to find a way across.
That's good to have. Okay. Going in this with a little bit more confidence. All right, that would kill me. Okay. There's clearly something here, otherwise they wouldn't have. Just a manuscript. I don't get. This was just an ambush, or not. Okay. Stress me out a little bit. Just a little bit. I don't even know why I'm hitting these checkpoints.
The story I had written in the cabin had come true. Touched by the dark presence, I had written a horror story. But the
one sec, come here, I'm just gonna go to the bathroom.
Was incomplete, and the last unfinished page of the manuscript still sat in the typewriter in the cabin study. If I could get back there, if I could read the page, then I could write my own ending to this story and save Alice. Making her way through the water pipe alone, Cynthia was angry at the writer. Foolish young man, taking unnecessary risks. And the way he broke the rules. Didn't he understand what was at stake? Since the terrible days in the 70s, she hadn't wavered once, as hard as it had been. She was tired of protecting the town all these long years, and now only wanted to rest.
Do you find it funny how it went through nighttime? I I let myself get hit too much there. Son of a bitch. Oh, it's that far ahead. Oh, God. Damn it all. So annoying. God damn it.
Watch your back.
God damn it.
Recognize the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Safe haven. Safe haven.
Waiting a very long time for you. It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. The well-lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
Oh, we won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us? Hmm? I want a secret route, a lit route, old water pipe. Something was damaged at the transformer yard. It's draining all the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside.
God damn it. I have no weapons. This is not good.
Weaver had sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades. I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it.
Hmm. 4 bullets left. I don't know how I'm gonna survive this. Holy shit, I thought he was dead. Fuck.
Started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring it back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. Witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, he left only one thing behind him, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story, and none of us will survive to see the end. Darkness isn't stopped. She'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it.
He still talks to that's me. Not good.
In television, beyond, from below, we have both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light. The darkness stays with you. You sustain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now? Gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend.
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
Man, am I gonna be easy?
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
Sarah was almost starting to relax. Maybe they could turn this into a win yet. Suddenly, there was a piercing sound, like a table saw gone wild, as 100 birds made out of shadows swarmed into the rotor. The chopper bucked wildly and the board lit up, telling her what she already knew. They were going down. Barry Wheeler screamed next to her.
God damn it.
Barry! Sheriff Baker! Sarah!
The crash site looked bad, but as far as I could tell, the wreck was empty.
Nothing. Okay, moving on. This episode was long.
Kid.
I have a different ending in mind.
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I knew you'd be all right.
How's that?
The flaming eye of Mordor?
Laugh it up, funny man. Didn't we have somewhere to go?
Weaver will meet us at the dam.
Please, please, we can. Yes. Barry, go up ahead.
Oh, man. Oh, jeez. Here we go again.
Oh, shit.
I should have kept that gym membership.
You see those lights? That's the elevator we need to take.
I'm a little bit at ease.
Safe.
That was... wow. I think we're okay.
Hey, Al, I got a bad feeling.
Let's keep our eyes open.
Oh. Al, let's be careful, huh?
Wait, call the elevator. I'm keeping watch.
I can hear something moving around.
There we go. A little bit better. It's just that, like, scariness factor, it's just the difficulty factor with this shit.
Heads up! Here they come!
Oh no! Oh no!
They're coming! We have to hold them off!
There we go.
Something Zane left behind. Something to fix this.
Gee, could you be a little more vague?
Thomas Zane? Seriously? Might as well be Paul Bunyan or Bigfoot.
Yeah, well, he was real.
Something's broken. Hold the button down so we can get in.
Of course. want, like, a normal...
outnumbered. The searchlight could even the odds.
Okay, I am running this way. That's a checkpoint. I think this is just obstacle course stuff. I don't have to kill something in.
Zane knew he had to remove all that had made this horror possible, including himself. That was the only way to banish the dark presence he had unleashed and now looked at him through the eyes of his dead love. But he also knew that despite his best efforts, it might someday return. So even as he wrote himself and his work out of existence, he had a soul as insurance, an exception to the rule. Anything of his stored in a shoebox would remain.
A shoebox?
It was active during the Second World War. They operated here back then. They must have built this.
Yes, they did. It's my place now. Because 6 and 33 and 118 need changing soon, and I don't want to climb up the ladder to change them because it's very late and I'm tired. And if you take it, I won't have to do that anymore.
The page was autobiographical, a memory from my childhood. But I didn't write this. It was a page written by Thomas Zane. None of them were supposed to exist anymore.
Alan, 7 years old, would fight sleep to the bitter end. When he did sleep, he soon woke up, screaming, the nightmares fresh in his mind. One evening, his mother, sitting by his bed, offered him an old light switch. She called it the clicker, and flicking the switch would turn on a magical light that would drive the beast away. To imbue the talisman with all possible power, she added that it had been given to her by Alan's father. Alan never knew him, and anything of his took on mythical proportions in his mind. With the clicker firmly in his hand, Alan finally slept like a baby. Now, almost 30 years later, Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
My mind swirled. I'd given the clicker to Alice, yet it was here. Zane had written it into existence in a story I had written. I can get to her now. I can finish this.
All right. So tired. This episode took 2 hours. Here we will pick up with episode 6, the final episode, at a later date. Well, thank everyone that came by today. Sorry for the crash earlier, but you know what, stuff happens. So yeah, I'm gonna call it. I will be streaming later on today with Tales of Arise, and then more Sinking City later tonight. So yeah, see you all later.